world. Hello guys, it's Ari and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a really special video for you guys. Namely, I'm going to do the Q&A as I already announced on my Instagram. But before moving on, please don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe. Just do that, why not? So let's move on to the Q&A. This video will actually consist of two parts. First of all, I'm going to answer all of your questions which you left me on my Instagram. But as there weren't really much, I choose for the second part of this video a website myself with other questions, which I'll link in the description. And I'm going to answer a selection of that one too, because I thought it was funny. So let's move on to the Q&A. I actually wrote all of your questions down on this paper here, but I haven't really thought about it, and I haven't thought about in which order I'm going to tell them to you. But let's just start with the first question. Where is a place you still want to travel to? There are a lot of places which I really want to see once, but I think my number one is New York, but there are a lot of places which I think it will be fun. I want to travel to Sweden, to Australia, although I'm a bit scared of the animals there. I want to see the rest of the United States. Canada sounds fun. Mexico, Costa Rica. It will be... I want to see everything, but New York is definitely my number one. Oh yeah, and don't feel left out if I haven't listed your favorite country. But because I think I'll want to go there too once. But let's move on to the next question. This is actually a funny one. Is YouTube your job? If it was my job, why would I upload so less? I'm not really happy about it, but it just happened. But I love to do YouTube. I love to make videos. I actually did it all my whole life, but I was too scared to upload them. But now I'm not scared anymore, so that's fun. But my real job these days is the supermarket. I'm going on... I'm struggling to find my words, but... I'm working at the vegetable section of the supermarket, and it is a lot of fun. So I want to, yeah, it's nice. Let's move on to the next question. What are you going to study next year? I'm going to study economics and rights. I don't know if that's the right description, but otherwise you can, well, you are going to see it under there. But it's a combination study, and I think it's really fun. And as I'm a bit tired of my gap year, I really want to go to study. So, yeah. So let's move on to the next question. Which one is fun to do next? Do you have a YouTube role model? No, there are a lot of YouTubers which I follow, but it's not that they are my role model. I am myself. So I want to do everything I like and not just because someone else does it. I follow a lot of YouTubers and I watch videos. I actually think my Story Animated and Story Time Animated are really fun to watch. But that's not just really a role model or something. There are some channels I'm subscribed to, which I watch a video if it is my recommendations. But it's hard to list them right now. Alright, there are two more questions of you guys. The next one. My favorite chess opening. As some of you guys know, I don't know if I already said that, but I play chess and I think it's really fun. And there are some openings, but it's really hard to learn. I used to just keep it at the basics, but I think it's the time to work on my repertoire, and I'm going to try new stuff, which I can't spoil to you right now, everything, because Who knows who sees this video? How do you say that? The Spanish for knife opening, it's really literally translated, so I don't know if it's correct, was always my opening, and I think everybody knows that, so I can say it. But maybe it's time for some change, but that always was my favorite opening. Okay, I'm talking too much about this, because most of you will not know where I'm talking about. Maybe I'll edit it a bit. So let's move on to the last question. It's not really a question, it's about secondary school. And if I can tell you some stories about that. And there are a lot of stories about that. I think I can make a separate video about it, but let's just... I'm going to think about it first. I'll pause this video for a moment. Alright, I'm recording this for the sixth time or something, but I can't find the right words and I'm... It's hard, you know? So this time I'll try to keep this one for sure. I graduated high school last year. I did Ateneum. I think a lot of people don't agree with me as I say that I was a bit sad that the final exams were cancelled. Because it's just something that I miss. You know, it's hard. After all, my grade list wasn't really bad or something, so that didn't really mind. But I graduated with a science profile. I did physics, science, I think you call it that way, but... what did I do more? Economics, mathematics B. I think I'm forgetting stuff. Dutch, of course, English. What else did I do? French. And I can't think of more right now. in the editing phase, I'll put it in this that one there. My favorite subject was, of course, economics, as I'm going to study it this year too. But I also really, really like mathematics. That was just fun, I think. And my least favorite subject, I don't know. Sometimes I just thought there were some, boring stuff. But I actually liked all of the subjects. Sometimes I had a bit effort with focusing on my physics and science. That was hard. And now I have to think about what I'm going to tell you next. Do I have some funny facts left? I was really boring in high school, I think. And a bit of a loner, but not at all. You know some people who describe their high school time as friends with everybody, but also with no one? I think I was a bit of that person type. I talk with everyone and so. That was me. I graduated really early. And there were some stuff going on, so that's why I decided to take a gap year. But I actually missed studying a lot. I missed the good times in high school because I really liked it. And when I was in high school, I could never have imagined to say this, but I want to go back. That's just... I think it's normal. Do I have some more good stories about high school? I had to travel a lot in high school, so there were some sad moments. I couldn't handle the fact that I sometimes missed the train and I didn't want to be late. Especially I had like we had like a station with in which I had to bike for 4.5 kilometers. That's going really well. It was sometimes really hard because we had a station closer, like 2.5, 3 kilometers, I think. But then you have to switch trains, that was really hard because there was also the fact that you had to park your bike on the opposite of the station, and then you have to cross the station again, and sometimes these things closed before I could bike, and then I just got really stressed because then I knew I was going to be late. But if I parked my had parked my bike before those things that did this, I knew I would be on time. But the things were closed. But if they opened again, I could run really fast and check in and be on time in the train because there were some seconds. And sometimes the train was late, 5 minutes or something, and then if I had to switch stations, I run really fast, but it was a really long distance, so I also missed it sometimes. And there were the most stressy moments of high school. I bet I had more stress at the train station than at school. Funny story. I also got really stressed sometimes at school, but it's not really good. Some of you might remember some stuff. That's not a good thing about me, but maybe it is because I'm a bit of a perfectionist. It could be an advantage, but most of the times it was a disadvantage. Do we have some more funny stories? I work, but I always was on time with projects and deadlines, and I actually sometimes did my homework right before the test. That's just, I have to be honest, it's, I don't know. I always got good grades, and it wasn't really a problem, so I actually did most of the times did my homework, but not on the right time at the right moment. I did it just too late. But I was always on time with paperwork, with projects, stuff like that. Okay, that were my fun stories, I think. And this video is now 8 minutes long, but I think it will be 4 if I could all ask all the thinking or something. If there will be more funny stories during the second part of my video, I'll definitely say it to you. Oh, that's fun to tell. My most embarrassing moment. I already thought about it a bit right before this. But I think my most embarrassing moment was when the... I can't come up with the word. I'll put it right here again. Of my... pants broke, and I had a long sweater that day, so I had to, the whole day I pulled it so that it will be stretched out so that no one sees it, and I think I succeeded in that, but it was hard that day. It happened really early in the morning, and I had to Okay, it happened around 8:15 or something in the morning, and I had to be at school until 16:50 or 8:15 p.m. I'm struggling. This is hard. I'm not a great at improvising. I discover now. So there will be a lot of not really smooth things in this video. But let's just move on to part two. It's okay. So the questions of the website which I choose are less complicated than this one. So it will be fast questions. But I have to read it because I don't remember them all. So let's just start. Do you sleep with your window open or closed? It really depends. I can't really. If it's really hot, I have to keep my window open, and I really love to have some ventilation and stuff. Otherwise, I'll get really hot. But I can sleep with both. But it really depends. If it's cold, I want to close my window, but then it will be hot and it's hard to sleep then. Okay, I'm talking again really much, but okay, next one. Do you sleep with your duvet tucked in or not? I can't sleep with my duvet tucked in. It's impossible for me. If it is tucked in somewhere, I'll grab it out. Okay, that wasn't the intention, my intention. But I can't sleep it that way. Do you take the shampoo or conditioner from a hotel? That also depends. If it's still closed, sometimes I take it because, but only if it's good stuff, which I actually am going to use, because I think, do they throw out that things if someone left? I don't know, but if it's good stuff and I think I'm going to use it and it's still closed, then I sometimes take it because that's nice. Do you use post-it notes? No, not really. I tried, but it failed. This is really a strange question. Have you ever stolen a road sign? No. No. Are there people who have stolen a road sign? Leave it in the comments. Do you cut out coupons without ever using them? I used to do that a lot because just when you're a kid, it's just fun to rub some stuff. And but now I don't think I'll do. Only if I'm bored and there are things on the table and I want to play with it, but not really. Yeah, only if. Yeah, it was something which I did as a child, but not right now. Do you prefer being attacked by a bear or a swarm of bees? I don't want both. It's a tough choice. I think a swarm of bees is the chance higher that you survive. I think it's less scary than a bear, but I'm scared of both. Do you always smile at photos? It don't look really great. If I smile on photos, yeah, it's a tough question because if I'm happy, I smile, but that won't say that it looks great because it don't, just don't. Okay, do you count the steps when you walk? No, I actually did count. So sometimes, or not always, but I sometimes count the steps on it. I'm losing the word again. It will be here again. Yeah, I sometimes just do that, but not when I walk. That's strange. It's not a good habit, I think. Do you sometimes dance without music? Yeah. But then the song is in my head and I'm practicing it, and I don't do it really much. I prefer just listening music while I dance, but yeah, sometimes. Are you biting your pen? Right now, not a lot. I used to do that when I was nervous, but that's also not a good habit. I don't, yeah. There are more good, bad habits. But in primary school, I used to do that a lot, and that was not good. But now, not really much. I think there are some other things which I do as I'm nervous, which aren't good too. But biting my pen, I think not anymore. What is your favorite song this week? It's actually the week before Eurovision, so I'm listening a lot of Eurovision songs. The songs of Kaino are definitely my favorites. Not definitely. There's another song which I listen a lot to. I also listen to, but Spirit in the Sky and Monument are just masterpieces. And I recently started listening to Bulletproof of Daughter, which is great too. Okay, next question. What do you think of men who wear pink? I think it's no problem. If girls can wear blue, why men can wear pink? So if they want to wear pink, just do that. If girls can wear things of boy stuff, I think it should be also be the opposite. I think, yeah, it's just strange that that isn't normal right now. Do you still watch cartoons? Not really. There are a lot of other things which I prefer, but sometimes if there isn't really anything on TV, I see that, I'm just going to watch, but not, yeah. Watching cartoons, it's okay. It's no problem, but I don't do it recently. I don't do it frequently. Where would you bury your treasure if you had one? That is a really hard question. I obviously can tell you guys that because it's a secret. It will be a secret, but I don't know where I'll bury it. It's just at a place where no one will ever find it except for myself. But I have to remember where I left it. That's hard. Okay, next one. What do you drink with your dinner? It's not every day the same. That would be strange. But I love to drink tea. It's good. Tea is always good. But yeah, sometimes some milk or fake milk or stuff like that. Or orange juice or something. Not with my dinner. Most of the times I don't drink with my dinner, but I drink after my dinner. You know what I mean? Yeah, you do, probably. Okay, next one. What is your favorite food? It used to be spinach all the time, but yeah, there are a lot of things which I love. Sweet potatoes are really nice. I really love vegetables, just baked vegetables or something. I actually eat a lot of things. I love a lot of things, so it will be a really tough choice. What movie can you watch over and never get tired? I don't have such a movie. I think this will be the case with the series Friends, which I'm really into right now, but I hope to be into it for a long time. Yeah, that series, it's great. It's great. I'm a big fan. But I don't have that really with movies. But there are a lot of movies which I already seen. But then if someone's watching it, I really want to watch it with that person. It keeps from being fun. But I don't have a specific movie or something. Who is the last person you kissed? I never kissed. I've never done it in my life. Have you also been a scouting girl? No, I thought about it, but no. I do chess and I try to do some volleyball right now. And I think that's enough. And then the last question which I wrote down. When was the last time you wrote a letter? I don't know, writing letters is from him. I write a lot of things at birthday cards and something. But I don't think you can count it as a letter. But I don't know what you can count on as a letter. I write cards every time it's someone's birthday, so that would be really risky. But real letters, yeah, I have to think about it. It's a while ago. I don't know. So that were all of the questions. If you like this video, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe. I've already said that, but just do that, why not? And then I'll see you next time. Bye!